welcome to the Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is going to go over some calculations involving pH, pOH, our H plus concentration or hydroxide ion concentration, and Kw. So as a reminder, pH is a way of expressing our hydrogen ion concentration in a solution. And if you watched the tutorial that gave a general overview of acids and bases, we will use H plus interchangeably with H3O plus, understanding that free protons don't exist in solution. They are going to join with a water molecule to give the hydronium ion. But for our purposes in this video and for the sake of clarity, we will use simplification H plus. Now we tend to use pH to describe the hydrogen ion concentration of a solution instead of just reporting the hydrogen ion concentration of a solution directly, because generally these concentrations are very, very small, and pH gives us an easier way to express this value. Remember that the pH scale is a log scale, and that means that for every change by 1 in pH, the hydrogen ion concentration changes by a factor of 10. Remember also that pH is equal to the opposite of the log of our hydrogen ion concentration. And so that as our hydrogen ion concentration decreases, the pH of our solution increases. So you can probably see the relationship here, where if we have a solution with our hydrogen ion concentration equal to 10 to the negative second molar, that gives us a pH of 2. If we had a hydrogen ion concentration that's 10 to the negative 7th molar, that would give us a pH of 7. But what you'll notice is that as that hydrogen ion concentration decreases, our pH increases. The other important thing to note, again, is that as your pH changes by a factor of 1, let's say we were going from a pH of 7 to a pH of 6, in this scenario, our hydrogen ion concentration would increase by a factor of 10. And if we were to go from a pH of 6 to a pH of 5, our hydrogen ion concentration would increase by another factor of 10. Meaning that if we were to go from a pH of 7 to a pH of 5, our hydrogen ion concentration would increase by a factor of 100. And if we were to go from a pH of 7 to a pH of 4, that would mean our hydrogen ion concentration would increase by a factor of 1,000. So if we know the pH of a solution, we can calculate the hydrogen ion concentration, or vice versa, if we know the hydrogen ion concentration, we can calculate the pH. And so if we rearrange this equation here to solve for the hydrogen ion concentration, what we get is that our hydrogen ion concentration is equal to 10 raised to the negative value of the pH. We also know that our hydrogen ion concentration times our hydroxide ion concentration is going to be equal to 1 times 10 to the negative 14th. This is our value here of the ion product constant of water. This is a constant at 25 degrees Celsius. And so if we know our hydrogen ion concentration, we can calculate the hydroxide ion concentration, or vice versa. We can also use a similar equation to calculate what we would call the pOH of a solution. And the pOH of a solution is giving us an indication of the hydroxide ion concentration of our solution. So just like where the pH is equal to the opposite of the log of our hydrogen ion concentration, the pOH is equal to the opposite of the log of our hydroxide ion concentration. And if you were to do a little bit of manipulation to these equations here, what you can rearrange these to find is that your pH plus your pOH is equal to 14. The other important thing to remember is that when using these equations, when we represent concentrations in brackets, that indicates that these concentrations must have units of molarity, or moles per liter. Okay, so let's practice one here. Let's find the pH of a solution if our hydrogen ion concentration is equal to 3.8 times 10 to the negative 8th molar. So we're looking for the pH, and we can find the pH by taking the opposite of the log of our hydrogen ion concentration. So if we take the opposite of the log of 3.8 times 10 to the negative 8th molar, what we'll get is that taking the log of 3.8 times 10 to the negative 8th will give you a value of negative 7.4. And then pH is the opposite of the log, which will give you a value of 7.4. So try this on your own, and if you're not getting the same answer that I do, make sure that you're inputting numbers and scientific notation correctly into your calculator. So you want to make sure that your calculator is taking the log of this entire value here. And generally speaking, when you're putting numbers and scientific notation into your calculator, you need to either make sure that you're using an exponent key, something like EE, or sometimes it looks like EXP, or that you're putting this entire value in parentheses and then taking the log of this value. Oftentimes, if you're not getting the right answer, but you're setting up the problem correctly, it's because you're not putting this number correctly into your calculator in scientific notation, and your calculator is potentially taking the log of something like 3.8 and then multiplying that by 10 to the negative 8th. So we want to avoid that. You want to take the log of this entire value, 3.8 times 10 to the negative 8th. Okay, I mentioned a few slides ago that pOH is a way of expressing the hydroxide ion concentration in a solution. And so if we know the hydrogen ion concentration in a solution, we can use that to calculate the hydroxide ion concentration. And if you know the hydroxide ion concentration, you can use that to calculate the pOH of a solution. Remember that if our solution is neutral, because of the autoionization of water, and again, I'm writing this here in a simplified form, in a neutral solution, the hydrogen ion concentration will be equal to the hydroxide ion concentration. And so in a neutral solution, these would both be equal to 10 to the negative 7th molar. The other useful relationship that we can use with respect to pH and pOH is that your pH value and your pOH value sum together to give you 14. And so what we'll see is that just like with this expression here for KW, which indicates that if our hydrogen ion concentration goes up, our hydroxide ion concentration must go down, or vice versa, if your hydrogen ion concentration goes down, your hydroxide ion concentration must go up, is that pH and pOH also have an inverse relationship. pH is lower when our hydrogen ion concentration is higher, and as our pH increases, our hydrogen ion concentration gets smaller. We're going to see the same relationship with pOH and our hydroxide ion concentration. If your pOH is very, very high, that indicates a very low hydroxide ion concentration, and as your pOH decreases, your hydroxide ion concentration increases. So it's another way to indicate this relationship of your hydrogen ion and your hydroxide ion concentrations in solution. And you can see that we see the same relationship here with pH and pOH, whereas one value increases, the other decreases, and vice versa. Note that if our hydroxide ion concentration and our hydrogen ion concentration are equal to each other, at 25 degrees Celsius, these would both be 10 to the negative 7th molar, and both our pH and our pOH would be equal to 7, and our solution is neutral. And so just to recap, if your pH is lower than 7, we say that that solution is acidic, and that's going to correlate with pOH values that are greater than 7. If your pH is greater than 7, we say that that solution is basic, and that's going to correspond with pOH values that are less than 7. Okay, so let's practice. Let's find the hydroxide ion concentration of a solution if the pOH is 9.28. So here we're looking for the hydroxide ion concentration. We know that the hydroxide ion concentration is going to be equal to 10 to the negative value of our pOH. And so if we take 10 raised to the power of negative 9.28, we'll get a hydroxide ion concentration that's equal to about 5.25 times 10 to the negative 10th molar. Okay, what I've included in here is a few that you can try on your own. So now would be a great time to pause this video, try a few of these, and then we'll come back and check your answers. Okay, so to find the hydrogen ion concentration of a solution with a pH of 3.49, we're going to use the equation that says that our hydrogen ion concentration is equal to 10 to the negative pH value, so 10 to the negative 3.49. And if you put that in your calculator, you should get a hydrogen ion concentration that's equal to 3.23 times 10 to the negative fourth. To find the pH of a solution, if your hydrogen ion concentration is 4.1 times 10 to the negative sixth, we know that our pH is equal to the opposite of the log of our hydrogen ion concentration. So we would take the opposite of the log of 4.1 times 10 to the negative 6, and you should get a value of your pH that's equal to 5.4. And so just thinking about what we understand about the acidity of solutions, note that this hydrogen ion concentration is bigger than 10 to the negative 7th molar, so we would predict that the solution is acidic, and our pH value represents that as well. Now this third one here is a little bit tricky. Remember that we said that these equations that I've written down below assume concentrations of molarity. So if our hydroxide ion concentration is given to us in millimolar, we would need to convert that to molarity first. And so if our hydroxide ion concentration is 1.5 times 10 to the negative second millimoles per liter, we can convert that to units of molarity. There are 10 to the third millimoles in every one mole. So we would have a hydroxide ion concentration that's equal to 1.5 times 10 to the negative fifth molar or moles per liter. And then if we want to find the pOH is equal to the opposite of the log of our hydroxide ion concentration, which in this case is 1.5 times 10 to the negative fifth molar. And we would get a pOH of 4.8. And then the last problem here, find the hydroxide ion concentration of a solution with a pOH of 11.3. Our hydroxide ion concentration is going to be equal to 10 to the negative pOH value. So 10 to the negative 11.3, which would give us a hydroxide ion concentration of about 5 times 10 to the negative 12th molar. Okay, but we can also use these equations in conjunction with each other. So what if we know the pOH of a solution and we're asked to find the hydrogen ion concentration of a solution? Well, what you'll probably notice is that there are a few different ways to do this. So we could use our equation here to find the hydroxide ion concentration by taking 10 to the negative pOH value and then using our hydroxide ion concentration to solve for our hydrogen ion concentration. We also know that pH plus pOH equals 14, and so we could use this relationship here to solve for our pH and then use our pH to solve for our hydrogen ion concentration. This tends to be the way that a lot of people like to prefer to do these problems, but you can certainly do it the way I just described on the previous slide as well. So if we know that the pH plus the pOH is equal to 14, and our pOH is 5.18, that means that our pH value must be equal to 8.82. And now that we know the pH value, we can solve for our hydrogen ion concentration, which is going to be equal to 10 to the negative pH value. So 10 to the negative 8.82 is going to be equal to 1.51 times 10 to the negative 9th molar. Okay, what if we were asked to find the pH of a solution if the hydroxide ion concentration is 9.9 times 10 to the negative 11th molar? Again, there's a few different ways you could approach this problem. So you could use your hydroxide ion concentration to solve for the pOH. And then we know that pH plus pOH equals 14. We could also solve for our hydrogen ion concentration, knowing that the hydrogen ion concentration times the hydroxide ion concentration is 1 times 10 to the negative 14th, and then use our hydrogen ion concentration to solve for the pH. So I'll do this problem this way in this example. If we know that H plus times OH minus is equal to 10 to the negative 14th, and we know our hydroxide ion concentration, we can solve for our hydrogen ion concentration, which in this case will be equal to 1.01 times 10 to the negative 4th molar, and then We know that our pH is equal to the opposite of the log of our hydrogen ion concentration. And so in this case here, our pH is going to be equal to 4. Okay, I hope some of those examples were helpful. Mm-hmm.